Hey everyone, welcome back to New Jang City, where a lot has changed since the last time you were here. This is probably the biggest update that I've done in, quite a long time, actually. So let me get right into the actual facts of the matter. First of all, three full base plates of prime waterfront property have just opened up for development. Look at that. Three green base plates there, just waiting to be trimmed down a little bit with some of the foliage, and then just build away. I was able to open that up by moving the road back a full base plate, and thus moving the row of temporary housing structures back a full base plate. Basically just removing unused space that was behind there. Now this does mean that once I start putting in my custom structures, they will need to be a little bit smaller than originally planned, but if anything, that's a good thing because smaller things are quicker to build, and you know it takes me too long to build stuff. Now the reason I was able to move things back as far as I did is mostly that I've moved the rail back closer towards the edge of the table. So that alone freed up about a half a base plate or 16 studs worth. And I've just got the temporary, you know, preformed obvious temporary rocks in to just suggest where terrain features that have always been planned since the beginning will go in. But that's all just, it's going to continue to be there. It'll still be built up custom, but it'll just be a little bit thinner than originally planned, but it'll all work out just fine. I do have the track, unfortunately, having to go a little bit past the inside corner of the table here, but that's okay. I'll just smooth that out with a little bit of Lego beneath, and maybe it'll be kind of like a rounded inside corner. Now, there were some casualties of changing up the rail layout because I am using these 9-volt rail pieces, which are not as flexible as using the plastic ones. You don't have the benefit of flex track. I don't have the siding for my police train anymore, so that just had to go. Unfortunately, it won't fit. Not a huge loss because that was such a silly novelty thing. Also, over on this side, I lost one of my connectors between the inside and outside loop, one of them. I still have one other, so I'm still good for moving trains between the two loops. And I've added in this other new interesting feature. You can actually drive a train out there. It is powered track, but this is just the first time that I have ever shown with rail that there's more to the world in which New Jang City lives than just what you see here on the tables. I've done that with roads before, but never before with rail. I've also been able to square up a number of the rail crossings at roads, and that's not gonna be much to look at, but it's good for me. Now here's the big one. This is the big change, the major one. This is a view that you've seen before, just looking down the main street, goes on down into the downtown area, goes out to the edge of the downtown area, and now it just keeps on going straight through. Look at that. The main outer train loop actually crosses over it now. It's just a straight shot. No more kink in the road that was there before over on the right-hand side. I made that change as I was putting in the assembly square and rearranging the modular buildings over here. If you're new to my channel, or you haven't heard me say this many times before, the modular buildings are just placeholders for me. They are not permanent. They will eventually all be replaced by buildings of my own design, which is just my plan for the whole city, to have very little, you know, official Lego stuff. I want it to be a fully creative endeavor here. They look great, but they're just not me. I think they make every Lego city that uses all of them kind of start looking the same. But for now, they look great. They take up the space, and I've just basically upgraded the efficiency of the layout here, especially with the roads. And there's still an additional 16 studs of space behind those modulars, so it's all a 48 stud thick area for me to put in my larger buildings and additional skyscrapers and such. I'm just settling into this place. You know, originally the layout was fully determined by the primary priority of getting all the stuff from the old city to fit into this new space, but now I've been able to relax a little bit and fix it up. The change has opened up some additional space temporarily over here closer to the edge of the table, but my plan for how this is all going to be built up has not changed. I may actually take out one of those small side streets, not necessarily, but again, that just won't change the overall plan. And then moving past the downtown area, I definitely have some new options opened up down here because I've just kind of slid all of the temporary Planetary Defense Force stuff, the kind of placeholders for where the Planetary Defense Force base will be built. I've slid all that over to the side here, and I think I'm actually going to build it out in the direction of the civilian space stuff behind there as I move that out. I could leave it actually as kind of an L shape over here, you know, still build off in this direction, but I think I have the option now to bring in some more civilian stuff down here, up to 3 base plates worth of additional stuff. So that's nice just to have that option. And definitely I look forward to pushing some of the non-custom stuff away that's behind there, and I'll probably eventually phase out the temporary themed display idea. Earlier on, you may have noticed that I moved the Shell gas station that I designed to the opposite side of the little world here, as well as the service garage next to it. I'm considering this to be just a temporary placement for now, because I wanted to keep it in the city, but I no longer have the same exact shape of space towards the downtown area that's available for it. I'll probably eventually reshape the service garage section of it, but for now I'm just happy to have this custom design of thing in place of the official Octan station that was here before. Those are all the big changes that have been made. There have been a lot of little things that have been altered as well, but it's not really worth seeking all those out. As always, updates will be posted when there are updates. If you don't see updates from me on anything in particular, whether it's the Octan factory or anything else that you know that I'm working on, it's because there's nothing new to show. And there's nothing new to show because I've been doing all the other stuff that you've been seeing me doing. I will be getting back to focusing more on custom stuff once I get through the major release season. This is always how it works. It's very seasonal. A bunch of stuff comes out from LEGO. I need to review it because folks want to see those reviews. And then stuff, you know, gets a little bit more sane and I'm able to focus on the city a little bit more. Stuff comes out from Mega Constructs. I have to review that and I get back to the custom stuff. So it's a cycle, but it works for me and I'm happy with the progress and the rate of progress. So thank you for watching. Thanks for your patience. I'll talk to you again soon.